What's the size of the room?
It's interesting.
Yes. So we stay by the door.
All right, good morning. Can you all hear me at home? Just give me a little wave. Just wave at me, let me know. Thank you, Harris. Thank you for the thumbs up.
All right, can you all hear me? Because I can't hear me now. All right. Well, welcome to your Sunday Thanksgiving class. Today we're going to be our event yet. My name is Andrea. This is an all-level Vinyasa class. So we're going to give modifications. But it can be as challenging as you want it to be.
Oh, gratitude. We get to think of gratitude extra time today, don't we?
Thanksgiving. We got a lot of things to be grateful for, you need. But if we can earn back, we just lie on our backs. Lie on our backs.
I'm just settling in here, letting go of the morning.
Letting go of all of the things you got to do after this class to prepare. Let all of that go to you right here. Let your shopping list or your chores take over your class. Draw the shoulders down on the way in here. Let the legs lay open. We have the right side, the palms facing up 6 to 8 inches away from the body. You get to be here. Be intimate with your breath this morning. How close to your breath.
Andrea, you're fading in and out.
I'm not really saying anything. Can you hear me? I'm just lying on our backs. I'm going to go to the back of the room and talk and let you know.
You're fading in and out.
Are your earbuds connected, Andrea?
No, they're not actually.
Hold on.
Just hold on at home for me 1 minute. Just getting the headphones plugged in. You take about 3 more breaths here, lying on your backs. Two more breaths, deep inhale and a deep exhale. Take one more breath here. And then slowly begin to twist through the wrist and twist through the ankles. Gently nod the head back and forth from left to right. Slowly draw the knees into the chest. I'm coming to a happy baby. Lift the arms high and the legs high to the sky. Mm-hmm. And again, twist through the wrists and twist through the ankles. And go ahead and hug the knees in and gently begin to rock forward and backwards.
Coming all the way up to a seat. Pam, are you in here?
Yes.
Once you're up to a seat, circle the sun, reach the arms up high to the sky. If you're at home, just bear with us. We're trying to get the ear pods working. And exhale the hands, the heart center. Close your eyes right here. Keeping the eyes closed. Whatever it is that you need today, whatever it is that you're letting go of, you're embracing, you're honoring, you're thanking that you have in this world right now. Today's the day. You should be grateful every single day. Your intention close to your heart throughout this practice and throughout your day today. Remind yourself, when you are ready, take a deep inhale through the nose. Open the mouth and sigh it out. Again, another breath through the nose. Open the mouth, let it go. The sound of Om the next time you breathe out. Deep breath in. Go ahead and blink the eyes open. Reach the arms up high. Taking your first side stretch, drop the right hand down, tiptoe the fingers all the way out. Look up and under that left arm, drop that right elbow down to the earth if you can. Breathe. Press that left booty down as well. And then slowly come up, both arms come high, inhale. And then on the exhale, we're going to tiptoe the left fingers out, look up and under the right arm, pressing the right cheek down as well. Beautiful, slowly come back up high, both arms come high. Take that deep breath in. On the exhale, we're going to walk the hands out in front of you, drop the forehead down. Maintain your breath, yogi. And slowly walk the hands up. Come into that tabletop position. Get there slowly and mindfully. Stacking the knees right underneath the hips. We're going to drop the belly down, the booty up, and the gaze up as you inhale. For cat-cow, exhale, press the earth away. Round the back. Pause here for a moment just to feel the stretch. Again, inhale, drop the belly down, the booty up, and the gaze up. And then exhale, round the back like a cat. Pull the belly up and in. One more time, drop that belly down, booty up, and gaze up. The last time, around the back like a cat. Breathe. Beautiful. Come back to a neutral spine. Take the left leg and the right arm and reach it out. Really extend through, twisting through wrist and ankle once again. Beautiful. Airplane it out to the side. Bring it back to extended. Again, airplane it out to the side. Bring it back to extended. Yes, last time, airplane it out to the side. Drop that foot down right where it's at. Beautiful. Slowly lift. Reach your arms up high as you inhale. On the exhale, draw that left hand down, taking another side stretch, looking up and under that right arm. Beautiful. Slowly come up. Both arms come high. We drop the right hand down to the earth, taking another deep side stretch here, looking up and under the left. Pam, if you can't get it, I'll just talk really loud. They're right in front of my face. So both arms come back up high on your inhale. Beautiful. Hands come through heart center, right back into that tabletop. Lift that left leg up. Bring it back behind you. Again, we reach the right arm out, and then we're going to grab the foot behind the back. Lift, press, look up and over to the right. Breathe. One more breath. Release the foot back to tabletop position. Take your right leg and your left arm, reach it out, extend, twist it back to the ankle once again. We airplane it out to the side. And we bring it back to center. Again, we airplane it out to the side. We bring it back to center.
last time to the side, hold it here, and then drop the foot down slowly. Bring your arms up high to the sky, reach up, inhale. On the exhale, drop the right hip down, look up and lift that left arm, taking a side stretch. Beautiful. Slowly come up, both arms coming high on that inhale, left hip drops down. Really press that right foot in if you want, reaching that right arm over if you want the balance you need. Come lift the toes. Yeah, it's okay. I'll talk about it. Reach both arms up high, inhale, sorry, at home, coming through. Exhale, hands down to the earth. Lift that leg up, bring it back behind you. Left arm reaches out before I begin. We bend the leg, grab the foot behind the back, lift it up high, look over to you. Breathe. Release it back to extend and drop it down to that tabletop position. Curl the toes under, lift up for downward facing dog, out of the Savasana.
All right, at home, I'm going to be talking loud. Can you hear me now? All right. Breathe. Three breaths in, Adho Mukha. Two more breaths. Maybe frozen. Our screen freezes, just be patient.
Lift that left leg up high. Point and flex, rotate the ankle again, joint movement. Bend the leg, look up and under that left arm. Stretch in front of the body. Rotation with that knee, make big circles. Reverse the rotation. Nice, straighten the leg up, square the body up. Bring that left knee to the left tricep, shift yourself into plank and hold it. Left leg comes high. Left knee to the nose, shift into the plank and hold it. Left leg comes high. Left knee to the right tricep, shift, hold it here. Fallen star, we straighten out the left leg, reach that right arm high. Those of you falling into Hanumanasana, go for it. Breathe. Reach that right arm up, press that left hand into the earth. One more breath. Bring that right hand down. If you want the chaturanga, take your chaturanga. Otherwise, untwist. Left leg comes high. We drop into down dog. Stay in down dog. Two breaths.
This reception's terrible. Sorry about this at home, you guys. As long as you all can hear me, then we're good to go. Take the right leg high.
All right. Point flex, rotate that ankle. Welcome those cracks and pops. Bend the leg, look up and under the right arm. Rotation with that knee. Big circles. Reverse the rotation. Nice. Straighten that leg all the way up. Bring that right knee into the right tricep. Shift into the plank and hold. The right leg comes high. Right knee to the nose. Shift into the plank and hold. Right leg comes high. Right knee to the left tricep. Shift the body. Lean forward if you can. And then straighten that right leg out for fallen star. Reach the left arm high. Breathe. However deep you want to go in this, if you want to slide into Hanuman, you can slide into it. You're just warming the body. You'll need to be patient. Nice. Bring that left hand down. If you want to take the chaturanga with the foot out, go ahead. Untwist. Right leg comes high. You drop with the down dog. Stay in down dog. Three breaths. Adho Mukha Savasana. Activating every muscle in the body. One more breath. Left leg comes high to the sky. Bring it through for dragon pose. Step it on the outside of that left hand. Drop down to the back. All right. So adjust. Make sure the left knee is stacked on top of the heel. All right. A gentle rock back and forth. You want to take that left arm, reach it up high, twist to that left wrist, maybe snap the fingers. Take that left hand and bring it all the way back. Open up your heart. Open up the chest here. Right. Those of you that want to drop down to that right forearm or right elbow, maybe to go a little deeper, you can bend the back leg, grab the foot. If it's too much on the arm, pull that higher leg. Breathe. We'll stretch it into that right quadricep here. Really pull that toe close to the knee. One more breath. Release that knee. Bring the left hand down. Press up and step back into a high plank pose. Low plank, lower down halfway. Inhale, upward, hold your up dog. If you want cobra, then ground your legs. Look up to the sky. Breathe. Roll over the toes down, dog. Two breaths in now. One more breath. The right leg lifts. Bring it through for dragon pull. Set it on the outside. Stacking that right knee over the heel. Right. Release the left shoelace down to the earth all the way. Take that right arm and reach it up high if you want to fly. Bring it all the way back, all the way back. Open the chest, open the heart. Twist to that wrist, snap the fingers. You want to bend the back leg, grab onto the foot. If it's too much to do it on that left forearm, come back, high down. Twist, lift the right shoulder back. Release that foot, bring the right hand down. Press yourself up, step back into a high plank pose. Take the right hand and tap the left shoulder in the plank. We're just doing a couple of slow shoulder taps. We got 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Take the right arm, reach it out, front plank pose, and lift the left leg up. Bounce. Come back to high plank. Lift the left arm out, reach it out in front, lift the right toes up off here. Ground them into high plank, chaturanga, lower down halfway. Inhale, left forward, roll the shoulders back. Look up. Exhale, down dog. Pedal the feet, shake the head, yes, not a no, no. Intention, breath, gratitude. Look at how awesome your bodies are feeling. There's so much to be grateful for. Move forward, step or hop to the top. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. Circle the sun, come all the way up. Rotation in those shoulders. Exhale, hand to heart center. Close your eyes. Pull yourself in and up. Type in the Labanda Udi at Labanda. Remember why you're here today. When you're ready, reach the arms up on that breath in. Sit down, Uttanasana. Separate the feet so that they're right underneath the hips. If you can have the arms up, try to get them behind the ears, behind the head even. All right, you can stick the booty out, you can tuck it in. All right, do the one that's the most challenging for your legs, right? That makes your quadriceps scream. I know when I tuck my booty, my legs get on fire here, right? If I let it stick out, it like releases my quads, right? So if we tuck, we're using our legs more, all right? Arms up, three more. Two more, the gaze will be in front of the mat, on the floor, maybe a little bit further out. One more breath. Bring the hands to heart center. Sink down low. Take a twist, right on the hooks on the outside of that left knee. Look up to the sky over the left. Elbow, step, fly, or just slowly bring that right foot to the back of the mat for twisting lunge. Drop the right hand down, reach the left arm high. Slowly window it over to warrior two. Adjust your feet as you get there. I like to take my legs and my feet and really reach them out a little bit further. Roll to the outer edge of the right foot. Shoulders are down away. Pull the belly in. Get the ribs together. Yes. Reverse warrior.
Try to get the bend out of the left elbow. Yes, straighten that front leg and reach to the back. Beautiful cartwheel. So the right hand lands on the outside of the left foot or the block. Right? This is where the block can be our best friend. Left arm comes high, look up to the thumb. See how far back you can bring the arm in time. Floating half moon, if you can do it, otherwise half moon. Ardha Chandrasana. Breathe. Slowly come up to standing, hugging that right knee to the chest. Breathe. Take a figure four. Right ankle sits on top of the knee, hands at heart center, sink. Maybe your hands can touch the earth. Those of you wanting to go into a little bit of a balance here, you can squat down low, come high to the left tippy toes. Depending on how high, how advanced, right? Maybe bring the hands to heart center here. Maintain your balance. Bring the hands to the earth. Slowly come up. As you come up, right piece finger to the big toe. We're going to open it up for hand. Yes. Here's your neighbor if you need to. You can look to the right, look to the right. You can look to the left, look to the left. Bring the face back to the front, bring the leg to the front. Standing staff, just bring the hands down by the side, activating that right foot, right leg. We're going to lift and lower. Lift and lower. Lift, lower. Three more. Two more. Last one, hold it here. Drop that right foot to the left. Separate the feet again. Bring the hands to heart center, sit down. From here, they're slow. You got 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Take a twist. Left elbow hooks on the outside of that right. Just looking up to the sky. And then as slow as you can, step or float. Fly that left leg to the back. When you're twisting lunge, we're going to drop the left arm down right on you to try. How far back you can bring that top. Floating, Ardha Chandrasana. Wait. Yes. Sorry. Three. When you're ready, slowly come up. Pump that left knee in the chest. Totally missed something there. Get your asses right back to that twisting lunge. I got it. I got it. Wiggle it open for warrior two. I take it up as I go. Yo, please. Roll the shoulders down. I'm like, wait. Where did warrior two go? Bottom of the wing. Right seat down low. Hit the ribs in. Roll to the outer edge of that left foot. Yes, and if that knee is caving in, bring it to 12 o'clock. Knee and toes are 12. Reverse that warrior. Left hand drops right arm reach. Breathe. Now straighten that front leg, reach to the back. Straighten that right elbow as much as you can. Nice, and now we cartwheel into revolve triangle. So the left hand, if you can get it on the outside of that right, the right arm comes up. Now we float it, coasted into half moon. The right hand can land on that block, the earth. Or you can just leave it hovering. One more breath. Slowly come on up, hug that left knee in. Hug it in, hug it in. All right. Take the hands first. Figure four. Activate that left foot, flex or point. I find that flexing is a little bit better on this one. Right, touch the earth. Notice that stretch, the
deep stretch in that left hip when you touch the ground. All right, if you want to squat down a little bit lower to balance, maybe you come high to those tippy toes. All right, bring your hands up. Hands to the earth. We straighten the right leg. Grab on. Peace fingers to the left. Big toes. Open up your hand to the big toe. Get there slow. If you can look to the left, look to the left. If you can look to the right, look to the right. Bring that leg back to the front. Whoa. All over the place today. All right, stand step, flex that foot, hands out by the side, pull yourself in the upper leg. Look, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Drop that leg. Drop that leg. That's what we did, right? Yeah, circle the side. Ha ha ha. Exhale, forward fold. Forward fold. Inhale, lengthen halfway, hold this halfway. Again, fold the body. Exhale. Again, lengthen halfway, hold this halfway. Exhale, fold the body. Last time, lengthen halfway, and chaturanga, step back, high to low plank. Inhale to the up. Exhale, down dog. Drop to the knees if you want to take a break. You can either stay in down dog for 5 breaths, you can come to child's pose, or you can come into crow pose. You can come into crow pose. Maybe you put the knees in the back or in the armpits, you lean forward on those legs. Today you lift one foot, tomorrow you lift the other. 4 more breaths wherever you are. When you're ready, we're all going to step forward into yoga squat. Yogi squat. All right, so if it's too much on your legs, on your knees, on your back, on your toes, put the block underneath your booty for now. As you progress, you'll be able to remove it. So the hands, the elbows are going to be separating the knees, hands at heart center. Take a deep inhale. Open the mouth, exhale. Yeah, take that left hand on the outside of the left foot, right arm on top. Wrap the right arm around the back if you want that bind. Take the box. Look up and over that right shoulder. Okay? Maybe you don't bind up, maybe just wrap the arm or leave it up high, wherever you can open that chest. Bring it back to heart center. Inhale. Open the mouth. Exhale. Right hand on the outside of the right foot. Left arm reaches. Again, you can inner rotate, take the bind if you wish. Wrap that left arm around the back. Beautiful. Bring it back to center. Inhale. Open the mouth. Exhale. We're going to step back into a low plank pose. Inhale upward. Hold that up dog and drop the hip to the left. Look like you're rolling to the outside edge of that left foot. Feel that right shoulder open. Staying lifted. All right, come back through the center. If it hurts your low back, do this. That's why. Don't do it. Anything that hurts your body in yoga, don't do it. Stop yourself. All right, come back to the front. Look up. Activating Jalandhara, your throat chakra. Getting into the thyroid. Anytime we're looking up or down, right? So sit back in that child's pose. 1 breath together. Inhale through the nose. Open the mouth. Exhale. Come into downward facing dog. Let's take some salutation together. When you're ready, look forward. Look to the
absolutely not. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. Circle, come on up. Bring the hands to heart center. If you can close your eyes and do sun salutations, close your eyes, go inside. When you're ready, inhale, reach. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway. Chaturanga, step back, high low. Inhale, upward. Exhale, down dog. Look forward, step for halfway. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. Look down, rise up, pasta, uttanasana, roll back. Exhale, hands to heart center. Breathe. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, fold forward, padasana. Inhale, halfway. Step or hop back, chaturanga. Inhale, upward. Exhale, down dog. Look forward, step or hop to the top. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. Circle, come on up. Reach up, look up, roll. Exhale, hands to the heart. Inhale, reach. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway. Chaturanga. Breathe in to Urdhva Mukha Savasana. Exhale to Outer. Look forward, step or hop to the top. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. Come on up, yogi, circle. Exhale, hands to heart center. One more round, one more time. Inhale. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway. Step back, high to low. Breathe into that upward, hold that up. Exhale, down and up. Step for hop to the top. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. Come on up, yogi. Exhale, the hands to heart center. Just close your eyes and feel the echo here. Feel the echo. Feel the echo. And down by the side, hold the mountain pole. Pull yourself in and up again. Hold on, hold on, hold on. When you're ready, circle the sun, reach your arms up with you. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway. Step or hop back, high low. Inhale, upward. Exhale, down to go. Left leg lift. Bring it through onto the asana, crescent lunge. Yes, so you can have a micro bend modification on the back knee. If it's too much, you just lower it to the ground and be here. You can still strengthen from there. Reach the arms up top. Bring the hands together in prayer. Bring the forearms together and hover them 1 inch above on the inside of that left foot. Keep them low and shift to the back of your mat. Same stance with the legs. All right? With nice, strong Anjaleyasana legs, lifting up on the back tippy toes. Now reach the arms up high, same facing towards the back. Inhale. On the exhale, we're going to close forward for four and three. Bring the arms behind you for swan with that upward dog chest. Beautiful. Come up and stand again, hugging that left knee in the chest. Still facing that back wall. Still facing that back wall. We're going to take equal pose. Wrap the left leg around the right. All right, you can stand, you can wrap full. Left arm will come over on top. Does it matter which arm? No. Reach your arms up on the inhale. Exhale, fold forward. Fold forward in equal pose. Fold forward in equal pose. Slowly come back up. Keep your arms, left leg reaching out in front of you. Pendulum back, warrior three, right where you started. Drop the hands in the earth for standing needle. Activate that left foot, flex your point. All right, straight to the leg and then lift it up. It doesn't matter how high it goes. Breathe. Bend the leg, grab the foot behind the back with the right hand, lift it up. If you can grab the ankle with the left hand, try it.
Beautiful. Release the foot, step back into a low lunge, drop down to the back knee. Alright, and then sit back halfway, half power, Vinyasa. Draw your chin to the shin, not the forehead and legs. So if you want to go down with a nice flat back, those of you that want to take those humble arms, cross the hand behind the back, walk back on that heel, and then drop the top of the head down towards the earth. Really reaching those arms up behind you, clasping, straightening the elbows, squeezing palms together. Beautiful. Release the hands down here. Bend back into that right leg. Those of you that want to stay here, stay here. Those of you that want to slide into full Svanasana, either straighten out the front leg or just curl back over under into the back knee backwards as far as you can go for full swing. Wherever you are, close the eyes. Three more breaths, okay? Anytime you need to take a break, take a break. Beautiful. When you are ready, bend back into that right leg. All right, lean back into the same way we started. All right, hands are going to move down and rise up. All right, for Anjaliyasana towards the back. Cross the hand together, bring the forearm together, and you've got to come back over to the top of the mat. So switch, bring it back to the top, hands lower to the ground, hovering just like we started. Beautiful, root down, rise up, reach the arms up high. Yes, remember, a micro bend in that back knee if you need it. One more breath here. Beautiful. Bring the hands. I know we did something. I'm getting distracted up here. All right, so come forward. I know we got to come into a. Hug that knee in. We got to take our eagle pose. So we'll figure it out. I'll remember at 2 a.m. and I'll text all of you. Right arm comes up over the left. Like, hey, it was a warrior three, guys. It was a warrior three. All right, try to line up the elbows and knees and then fold the body down. Fold the body down. Let me figure out what's going on here. Yes, thank you, computers. We love them. You gotta love changing this life.
Yes, breathe, sing. When you're ready, slowly come up. Right leg comes out front, keep the arms, and then we pendulum back to that warrior three. Release the hands down for standing Hanuman. Yeah, bend that right leg, grab the foot behind the back. One more breath here. Beautiful, release that left foot. Go ahead and step the right foot down behind you. Sink down to that right knee and then sit back for half Hanuman. Straight to that left leg. So same thing we did on the other side, your knees almost. Almost, that is right there. All right, so we're gonna clasp the hand behind the back, squeeze the palms together, straighten the arms, and drop them to a humble half split. What did I say? Breathe. Squeeze those palms together. It's one thing to have the fingers, but get the palms together and notice the change. Yes, yogis. One more breath here. We're going to slowly bend into that left leg. Hands come to the earth. Hanumanasana. So you might stay right here in your lunge today. This might be your split. Maybe tomorrow you curl right toes and just begin to inch by inch, the knee back. Maybe you heel that front foot forward. You heel it forward. Heeling the foot forward. That's up today, right? That's up today. Great. Close your eyes. Five breaths. Fold. Two more, yogi. When you're ready, all you gotta do is
fall to the outside of that left. Slide that right leg around for Lord of the fish. Wrap that right foot, right leg around the left. All right, so those of you with advanced, you can take that bottom leg and fold it underneath, but make sure your whole booty is down and you're not sitting on that heel. Okay, take the left arm high, twist the body, look to the right, poke the elbow on the outside of that. The right arm is behind to help prop you up. Those of you who really want to get deep into it, take the left hand and shimmy it underneath the right knee. Take the right arm, wrap it around the back of your body. Take some shimmy. Yes. Do a lot of shimmying and scooching. Every time you exhale, really try to bring the body out. One more breath. Beautiful. Shift to the other side. Keep the legs right where they're at. Just look over to the left. Excellent. Come back to the front. Take both your legs for cow face, dandasana. Try to stack the knees on top of each other. Again, try not to sit on that heel, okay? So if you want to add the arms to help open your chest, give you some good neck workout here, take your right arm high. Left arm comes behind for the bind. If you have a strap or towel, you can even use your own hair. Yeah. All right, take a deep breath in and then fold forward. And then fold forward.
Yes.
One more. Now all you gotta do is come up high. Whichever arm you have high, go ahead and straighten them out. Bring the other arm high. Right? It's not right. It's not wrong. All right, take a deep breath in. And then exhale, fold forward. Just take notes, don't judge or compare it. Beautiful, come on up. Come on up. Loose the arms out. Yes, now. You come here to the left. Keep your feet right where they're at. Do not move your feet. Just walk your hands and body all the way around to the other side. Can you believe it? Did it work? Got it. So those of you coming into the modification of the Lord, you're going to take that right leg and straighten it. If you're coming into deeper posture, you're going to be here. So we're not in Dandasana yet. We're not stacking knees yet. We're in Lord of the Fish, so that left leg's going to be high, right knee's going to be down towards the earth. So if you have it, hold it under. Right arm comes high on the inhale, twist the body, look over on the left, poke the elbows. All right, those of you coming in that deep twist, shimmy. Take a minute and shove that right hand underneath that left knee. And you can be here forever, you know. And then if you feel like it's hard, take the left arm around the left. Breathe. Look to the back. Bring it out. We're activating the throat, getting into the thyroid gland. Remember the neck. Every time we're looking up, down, left, right, breathe. Bring awareness into your throat. Oh, one more. Release that and switch all the way to the other side. Just a little counter posture. Nice. Come back to center. Now we try to take the knees and line them up as best that we can. Some of you are going to be here, like, wow, this is crazy. Everybody in here is crazy. That's fine, too. You can still try. Smile at it. All right, now let's see. So left arm high, right arm behind for the bar. Again, towel, strap, hair, pet. Yeah, that's kids. He's a cat here, I bet. No. Take a deep breath in. That's me. Exhale, fold forward. Fold forward, notice the tension, smile at it, breathe with it, be grateful for it. Yeah. Like, did she just say be grateful for my tension? Yes. Come on up, yogis, take the arms out, and then bring that right arm high. If you're grateful to your tension, will it still be tension after you're done thinking it? Take a deep inhale. Exhale, fold forward. Fold forward.
breathing. Excellent. Come on. Come on. Release the arm. Straighten those legs out in front of you. Shake your legs. We're going to recline back. We're going to recline back to a high boat. To a high boat. God, I was going to say recline back to the back. So flex the feet as much as you can. Straighten the arms. Let's try to get them higher. Right piece, maybe to the big toe. Let's try this one out. Open the legs up nice and wide here. Sit up tall so it's easy to sink. Stick the chest up. Roll your shoulders down. You're squeezing the head in between the shoulder blades. Take the right toe into the right ear. Look over the left. You know, final expression of this, the right foot is hooked behind the head. Any of you want to take it, go for it. Smile. Switch to the other side. Maintain your balance. Yogis and maintain your balance. Left toe to the left ear. Attach them if you can. Or wrap the left foot behind the head. And look over the right. Straighten both legs. Let go of the feet. Bring the hands right here. Release Shiva. Here's the hard part. Wrap back onto the toes. See if you can do it without bending the legs. Yeah, okay, good job. Bring the feet together. Keep them high as you can here. All right, and then just let them go. High boat. Low boat. In low boat, we crunch for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. High boat, bring it up. Flex it. Bend the knees, we go left to right. With the knees in the opposite direction, slowly. We got 5, 4, 3, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hug those knees in, don't drop the feet. Low hold. Last round, we're 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Drop it down, hug the knees. Take a deep inhale. On the exhale, we're going to straighten the legs out. Reach the arms up over your head like you're stretching out of bed. Exhale, let them bow. And then just lie here on your mats for a moment to restore, replenish, reset. Let's come to a walk yourself up to a seat, open up to a wide legged straddle facing your right. So the knees are gonna want to go in different directions. Try to keep them up to the sky, just awareness to it, doesn't have to be that way. Reach your arms up on your inhale. And then on the exhale, walk the hands out. Try to have a flat back as much as you can. Remember, it's not about the forehead touching the ground first. It's about belly, chest, and chin. All right? Maybe the gaze is looking out to the horizon. Maybe your eyes are just closed here. You can rest those hands on a block. Maybe the chin on a block will help with that support and flat back. Surrender flat. Two more breaths, yogis.
If you're at home and you have the playlist on, we fast forward it to the next one, Is This Love? We're just slowing it down a bit.
Last breath here, walk it out as much as you can, last time. All right, so come up and together we're going to get into our low backs here. So taking a side stretch with intention, we're going to take the left arm high. All right, so your right arm, whether you're advanced or new to this, I can do it either way, but today I'm going to rest my right cheek, right temple into my right palm of the hand. So the left arm can really just hang over my head. It is all about that left lower, L4, L5, S1, right? On the low spine here, that low back. If you have any problems back here, go into your favorite position. Right, surrender here. We got the 8 breaths. Contain your breath. Stay. You're halfway through. Maybe you can take that elbow and drop it down to the earth. You're on the outside or the inside of that leg. Do the one that creates the most tension for you. Three more breaths. Feel that chest slightly rise up on the inhale. Notice everything your body is doing. Stay with the last breath here. Together, we'll take an inhale through the nose. Exhale. Slowly come out. Just sit upright. Hands will be on the knees. Palms face down. Close your eyes. Deep inhale. Deep exhale. Take that right arm high and step. Slowly into it. Take the left temple, left cheek, set it inside that left hand, just so that the body can really melt and dispose of your subconscious and worry about your head just hanging out in the middle. One more breath, last one, take it together, inhale. And slowly, slowly come on up. Just let both hands sit on the knees, palms will face down. Go ahead, bring both of the legs to the top of the mat. For Paschimotto, we're going to make sure that the meat on the sitting bones, you want to remove it so that you can feel the bones on the earth here, all right? Flex your feet so much your heels can maybe come up off the ground, pull the knee traps back, tighten the quads, reach your arms up, inhale. So see how we can fold forward like this, or we can sit up nice and tall. Stick the chest out and then fold forward. Think of belly, chest, and then chin. Maybe the gaze is at the toe. Maybe if you already have your belly and chest on the ledge, you want to drop the face down into the legs. That's fine, but try to have a flat back here so we're not tugging and pulling on that low spine, right? Fold forward two more.
Raise your eyes, flag is not down. Pull the shades down.
Last breath here, yogi. And then slowly come on up. Your counter
posture is going to be either reverse tabletop or reverse plank. So you're going to straighten those legs out and lift up so high the toes touch. If you're looking to the back, you're activating that throat, that thyroid, Jalandhara, right? Lift up high, high, high. Breathe. Come on, downward. Baddha Konasana, bring the soles together. Grab onto the toes, sit up tall, inhale. Exhale, fold. Let go of anything that's distracting to you. When you're ready, come on up slowly. Bring the knees together. Ooh, you know what? I want to do that one. We haven't done that in a while. It's so good. It's so fun. Hold on to your toes in Baddha Konasana. And butterfly, right? So, what's a butterfly that doesn't flap their wings? So, yeah. You know what I mean? We both. Good. Stuck in my brain now. Alright. Feels nice. Nice. Bring your knees together slowly. Recline down to the back. Now, this time, keep the hands on the knees and make a rotation here. Rotation. And then reverse that rotation. Nice job. You can drop the feet down, lift the hips up. For half bridge, those of you that are just screaming for a back bend all three times, go ahead and take down back bend. Otherwise, stay up in half bridge, stay up, keep it up a little bit. This is going to be so tight. Yes, stay up, stay up. If you're in back bend, straighten arms and legs, tuck your chin. Yep, try to walk hands and feet close together. Beautiful, excellent. If you're up, be up. One more. Deep inhale, deep exhale. Nice job. Come on down, come on down. Top four most important yoga poses you'll ever take in your whole life, yogis. Of course, one of them is going to be the back bend. Come on into it. Down to it. Hop up into it. The most important yoga poses you're ever going to take in your life. You paid all this money to be a part of Tula to have a healthy body. Start with a healthy spine. Come on into it. Come on into it. I got to do it too, actually. I got to do it too. I know. My back is tight, but I don't use it safe. Imagine a life without yoga. Right, guys? Imagine that. Would you? Say it out loud. No way. Yoga is hard, but it's harder without it. Yeah. Come on down, yogis. Come on down. Hug those knees into the chest. Life is hard, but it's harder without yoga. I found that out about 8 years ago. Go ahead and bring the legs together, airplane out the arms. If you're into eagling, you're going to cross that right leg over the left, scoot your hips to the right, and then fall into it. If you want to wrap the full eagle, go for it. And then look over to the right. A deep, deep spinal twist here. We're going to be here for about 7 breaths. While we're here, I'm just going to go over a couple of announcements with you all. I'm sure a lot of you know we're having a Black Friday sale that starts, 11/27, which is tomorrow, and goes through the 30th. We've got 15% off all of our retail, so those of you that were eyeballing the shirts, that'll happen tomorrow for the sale. Gift cards. If you spend $100 on gift cards, you'll receive 5 classes to use, or can apply that to another gift card.
Take another deep breath here, two more breaths. And then 25% off all packages. So 1 month, 10 class, 6 month, 12 month, you guys know. Come see me after class about that. That's if you're doing this challenge 3 days in a row in the studio. So you have to come yesterday, today, and tomorrow. So if you missed yesterday, just ignore all of this. Take one more. And if you are doing this challenge for the discount, I think it's up to 40% off totally, because you can combine the two, 25 plus 15. You can get two packages per person. So if I've confused you, because I've confused myself. Go ahead and come out, yogis. Hug the knees into the chest. Let me slowly come to that other side. No rush. Yeah, so that's good. Who here is doing that 3-day special thing? All of you. That's good. If you're not sure, you know, you can still get package specials tomorrow. 25% off, depending on what you want. We try to bring it out on the exhale, right? This is where the breath is awesome, right? We can deepen our twist. We have one more spot left for Jamaica, December 4th through the 9th. Jamaica. Okay, take the last breath here. Feel the chest rise up on the inhale. Remember that gratitude, that reason why you came here today. Slowly exhale it out. And come on out. Come on out. So we're going to come into the queen next. We're going to start through plow pose. You can start in waterfall if you want to start in a water fold. So arms high, legs high in your waterfall. You can chill out here because waterfall is a really calming, still pose here. We're letting all the blood flow in the opposite direction. If you have a block, if you were good enough to yourself to get a block today and put it underneath that booty for this waterfall, that's a plus. Raise your legs in the air if you need a block. Yep. All right, plow pose. Hands come to that back. Lift your feet up and let them drop all the way behind you. Get there slowly. All right, we're going to end in the queen. The queen is the shoulder stand, right? But let's get there coming through plow. So don't look left or right. Keep your gaze up to the sky, your eyes closed. Now, bring your awareness to that throat. Jalandhara. Mula Bandha, your perineum. Tighten that. Tighten your stomach. Mula. Uddiyana. All three locks is Maha Bandha. We know this. Tighten all three of your locks here, but maintain your breath. All right, slowly but surely, lift those legs up high. Now just adjust, don't worry about flexing or pointing the feet when they're up there, your body's doing enough, right? Maybe for your Instagram poses you'll flex or point, but for your class right now, we wanna relax. Let the legs hang out. If you can press the hands into the earth, maybe you can clasp the hands, pressing the arms into the ground as hard as you can. Notice that difference, right? Ah, the thyroid. Waking it up. If you have thyroid issues, these are the poses you want to visit. Right. Now take the last breath, and on the exhale, keeping Maha Bandha tight, we're going to bend the knee, coming into the deaf man. Coming into the deaf man's pose, we're keeping all locks tight here. We're cleansing the anal canal. We're helping our digestive tract to be detoxified. Strengthening the pelvic floor, taking all the pressure off that pelvic region so the cells can actually heal, move around a bit instead of being all crushed up all the time, right? Inversions are the king and queen of all poses.
When you're ready, slowly come on out. Come on out. We're going to find a fish pose. We're going to find a fish pose. You're going to sit on the hands. Palms will face down. Arch the back. Press the chest up to the sky. Scooch the elbows underneath you. And lift. Yes, yes, yes. And drop the top of the head to the earth if you can. Point your toes. Fish point their toes in Matsyasana. It's what you do. Excellent. Come on out slowly. Release the head. Remove the hands. And hug those knees into the chest. All right. Right knee stays in. Left leg stays out. We're going to take spinal twist here. Left hand stays on the outside. Left hand stays on the outside of the right knee. Scoot your hips to the right just a little bit. Scoot them so you can deepen your twist. Let the knee fall all the way down to the earth. And let the arm hang in the air. Look to the right. Let your kneecap touch the earth. Let the arm hang. I'll demonstrate for you. Okay, so leg on the ground, arm in the air. Instead of arm down leg, we're going leg down, arm in the air. Yes. Switch it up. Moon ceremony is on the 30th. Those of you that go to Maori and Jamie's moon ceremonies, they got a lot of fun. This whole room is filled. It's awesome. So that's 5:30 to 7:30. It's $25. Totally worth it. Come into the other side. Pause a minute in the middle. Hug those knees in for a second. Maybe lift the head up off your chest and neck one last time. Activating. Being aware of that growth. And then go ahead and switch. Put the head down. Bring that left leg into the chest. Right leg. Reach it out. Let the knee land on the earth. Let the arm hang in the air. If you're a scoocher like me, I like to scooch. Scooch. I jump over so I can deepen my twist. Okay. Feel the chest rise up on the inhale. Yeah, you want the arm to hang in the air in its most awkward, funky, stressed out place. You want to do the pose that's the hardest one for us. You don't want to do that. Not me. Two more. When you're ready, on that last breath, come on, bring it out. So you've got one last pose before Shavasana. You've got one last pose before Shavasana. If you want that pigeon pose, you can take the pigeon. If you're like, you know what, my hips feel pretty good. Let me flip over and get my arm, my shoulder strength. You can do either or. So if you're lying on your back, yes, you can cross that right ankle over the left knee. You'll thread the right hand between the legs and grab the back side of the thigh or the outside of the shin. If you want to flip yourself up and take a regular pigeon, you can take a regular pigeon. You just rock yourself up, bring the whichever ever leg forward. Holding a proud pigeon first, all right? Walking through the proud pigeon, maybe pull the left shoulder back and bend the back foot for the body. You can hook that foot into the crease of the elbow. Right arm comes up for that deep side stretch. Stay here, stay up and lifted if you're in that up high. If you're lying on your back, maybe it makes more sense to put the block underneath the head. If you take a shoulder stretch, my shoulder stretchers, cactus the arm if you've been doing yoga for a very long time. If you are in an intense spot right now, see if you can bend this top leg. There you go, if you want to. And then you can bend the bottom leg and set the left heel in the right side of your kneecap. As you go higher, there you go. You can scooch this closer to your back. Surrender five breaths wherever you are. Bring your thoughts back to the breath. Back to the body, everything that you're feeling, not thinking. Yeah. Sensation was the very first language you ever learned. Bring your mind back to sensation. Take the last breath here. If you put the weight on the elbows and right your pigeon, surrender the weight in the last breath. If you're in that shoulder stretch, slowly begin to bring yourself out. If you're in that regular pigeon, come on out, the mind on your back, go ahead and switch, but pause in the middle. Come to a neutral position just to feel. If you're on shoulder stretch, just bring hands down by side. Bring the opposite cheek to the mat. Just feel the open. And then shift to the other side. And it's good for you. And again, if you are taking shoulder, cactus. Whatever words we did, whatever you can look for. Whatever version we can look for, I'm going to try to feel it out. Yes. At regular pitch, we're always trying to keep that bowel pitch and that alone itself is beautiful. Heart opening, chest, ribcage opening, pose. Wherever you are, surrender, melt into your last moment. The weight of the elbows, you know, regular pitch, we try to bring the arms further out front. Down
The last three breaths here, surrender. Again, try to remove the weight from the elbows. If you're propping yourself up, just reach your arms out front. Last breath, we'll take it together, yogi. Only when it feels right, when it feels good. If you think you need to stay here a few moments longer, you're fine.
So coming out, we're going to just rest in the middle here. Those of you ready for final resting pose, Shavasana, go ahead and come into it. Those of you that want Sirsasana, headstand before Shavasana, this is the best time to take the king of all poses, putting pressure on the crown chakra right before Shavasana, they can do it. It's for lack of self-rejuvenation, one of the biggest stress relievers. If you're new at it, wait, one of our balance workshops, you need assistance in the after class, and I'll show you. You've got a headstand, try to keep it up as long as you can. If you're in Shavasana, just unwind, untwist.
Just let your body relax here. If you have music on, go ahead and turn it off at home. Try to get your house, wherever you are, your space as quiet as possible.
Take two more breaths and headstand if you are up. And remember to take child pose or rabbit for the comfort posture. Ah, yes, Shavasana. What happens to us in Shavasana? All of our cells can say, hey, thank you for this beautiful practice. We can heal. Harvard did a study that said the moments right after your yoga practice are just as healing, if not more healing, than the 8 hours of sleep that you get at night. What happens to us in Shavasana? Let yourself sink here. Surrender to the floor. Shoulders are down away from the ears. The hands are dead by the side. Palms are facing up. Take a deep breath in all together. Open the mouth and slide out. Lion's breath it out if you want to. Again, inhale as much air as you can. This is going to help relax you. Hold that breath in. Keep it in. Don't let any air out. Keep it in for 10 seconds, hold that breath. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Open the mouth and let it go. I have nothing left to do but relax the mind. Bring your thoughts to your breath. Bring your thoughts to the way the body feels sitting here, the way your clothes touch your skin. You come around with a nice cold cloth for your forehead so it'll feel right in my touch. Those of you that do not want a cloth, just raise your hand up in the air. So here we are. Take one last soft breath in. Separate the lips, exhale. Nothing left. Just relax your body. Let go of any distraction. Fly here in peace and try not to move. As soon as your thoughts go off, bring them back to your breath. And just relax.
begins to slow down and calm down. So much breath. So you're barely breathing in, you're so calm. You're so relaxed. Thank you.
the will of the shares and tokens.
Slowly draw your knees into the chest. Just roll over onto whichever side is good for you. Slide here a moment of peace and gratitude, love. Thank yourself for showing up to practice today. Guide yourself up to a comfortable seated Sukhasana towards the front, a cross-legged or Padmasana if you want your lotus. Sitting up nice and tall, bring the hands to the knees. Eyes closed. We'll sit in meditation for a few moments together. Just think of all the things in your life that bring you the most happiness, the things that you truly are grateful for, the people, the connections that you have, the jobs that you have, the cars that you drive, the clothes that are in your closet, the food that you have at home. Think of everything now and be grateful for it. Loving light and energy inside of your body and your heart to carry along with you through the day. Give yourself patience when you're with your family members and your friends. Make sure that you share love today, kindness always. Bring your hands together. We'll take three breaths. On the third breath, we'll welcome our biggest om that we've taken all year. So when you're ready, eyes closed, sit up nice and tall. When you're ready, inhale through the nose. Open the mouth, let it go. Again, inhale. Open up, let it go. And this time with an all big breath in. Showing up on this beautiful, special Thanksgiving day. The divine in me honors, recognizes, and cherishes the divine in each and every one of you. Namaste.
Namaste.
All right, ladies, good job. Remember, hand clasps go in the bin right outside the door for our bodies. If you want to clean your mats, we have cleaners in the back of the room. If you clean them, happy Thanksgiving, everybody.
Yeah, bye at home. We love you all. Thank you. Adios, amigos and amigas, mainly amigas.